Hello students, before we start our chapter, I would like to request you all to watch our introductory two videos given by me so that you will be clear about the three-step strategy to do Dhamaka in physics exams. We have given the videos in the description box, or you can just click on our videos displayed at the end of this video for either introductory two videos or the next videos. Okay then, let's enjoy physics by Mr. Patel, who has a long, profound experience of 29 years of teaching physics in Science School, Balachandi.
12.3 on page number 436. First and second examples are not in our course, is deleted. So third example of exercise. What is the shortest wavelength present in the Poisson series? You know the Balmer formula. That is a correct for shortest lambda of the Poisson series. That is, what is that? Nf is equal to 3, and ni is equal to infinity. This is a final orbit. The Nf is Poisson series. The electron jump from any higher orbit to the orbit number 3. So ni should be equal to any 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But what is the shortest wavelength? Then frequency will be highest, so the orbit will be the highest. So for shortest wavelength Poisson series, nf is equal to 3 and ni is equal to infinity. Now let us see the Balmer formula. 1 upon lambda is equal to r into bracket 1 upon, that for Balmer series it was 2, for Poisson series it is 3 minus 1 upon infinity square. This is 0, so r by 9, 3 square is 9. So lambda is equal to 9 by r. So 9 upon r, the Rydberg constant has value 1.097 into 10 to the power 7. That is, therefore lambda is equal to, take this up, 8.2041 into 10 to the power minus 7. Correct? This has value 1.097 into 10 to the power 7, not minus. So lambda is equal to 8.2041 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter. Convert into Austin unit. 1 Austin unit is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So multiply by 1000. Correct? So 8204 Austin unit, because this is smaller unit. Correct? So wavelength belongs to the, now which region? That is infrared. You know the red has about 7500 Austin unit. And, violet has 4000 Austin unit, or 400 nanometer also you can say. Yellow is average round about 600 or 580 or 550 also sometimes it is given in the book. It has actually two wavelengths, 95890 Austin unit and 5896 Austin unit. We can take it approximately 6000 also. Austin unit, or 600 nanometer, any you can say. Or if it is round about 500 to 400, then you can say yellow green and so on. So you know the spectrum. Yeah. Example 12.4. The difference of 2.3 electron volts separates two energy levels in an atom. What is the frequency of radiation emitted when the atom makes a transition from upper level to the lower level? Same energy. Right? E is equal to 2.3 electron volt. That is 2.3 into, convert into joule. 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. So now E is equal to energy emitted is h nu. So frequency emitted of the light, that is to be calculated. So difference of this energy level between two levels is 2.3. Difference is this energy level. Say this is E1 and this is E2, say you can see. This difference is 2.3 electron volt. So when electron jumps from higher atmosphere, it will radiate energy of the proton of having the energy is equal to h nu. E is the difference between of the energy of an electron in the two orbits. So E is equal to H nu, and so nu is equal to E by H. So E is given, energy difference is 2.3 into 10 raised to 2.3 electron volt, that convert into joules, that is into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joules. Upon H, Planck constant 6.6, exact it is 6.63, and something, sometimes they take as a 6.4 also, 6.64 or 6.63, here it is rounded off, that is 6.6 into 10 raised to minus 34 joules second. If it is given, you will have to take the value, use the value of the H which is given in the question. If it is not given, you can take this one also. So, nu is equal to 5.6, this calculation is, into 10 raised to 14 hertz, correct? Joules cut per second, that is hertz, vibration per second. Next question, 12.5. The ground state energy of hydrogen atom is minus 13.6 electron. Already we have studied, you know. What is the energy on the ground state? N is equal to 1 state. That is 13.6 electron. And most of the time at normal temperature, the electron stays in the ground state. What are the kinetic and the potential energies of electron in this state, ground state? What are the electron? That is N is equal to 1. We know that. Energy is given by the equation minus E square upon 8 pi epsilon 0 r. Kinetic energy is equal to plus, kinetic can never be negative, E square upon 8 pi epsilon 0 r. We have studied in the first lecture. And potential energy is minus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r. So total energy E is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So kinetic energy is E square upon 8 pi epsilon 0 r, and potential energy is just double but negative. If you correct, if you take the 4, 2 into 4, that is 8. So this is just double but negative. So you can say that kinetic energy equal to negative potential energy, that is equal to minus 13.6 electron volt, that is kinetic energy is 13.6 electron volt. Kinetic energy is equal to minus total energy, and potential energy is double than the kinetic energy. This is double but negative. So potential energy is minus double kinetic energy. Remember, so kinetic energy is equal to total minus energy. Total energy is E square upon 8 pi epsilon 0. And kinetic energy is also E square upon 8 pi epsilon 0, but plus. So total energy, kinetic energy equal to total energy with a minus sign. Correct? So total energy, kinetic energy equal to total energy minus, negative total energy. Now what is total energy? Minus 13.6, and minus it is. It is minus total energy. So that is equal to plus 13.6 electron volt. Potential energy is minus double kinetic energy. This is potential energy, it is double than this, you can see. But minus. So minus 2k. So minus 2 into k is equal to, what is k? 13.6. That is 72 point. So E is equal to minus 72 point, this is a minus, sorry. It is minus 27.2 electron. Again, you can calculate the total. So, total energy is will be 13.6 minus 27.2. If you do it, go reverse way, that is minus 27.2. Plus U plus K, U plus K, if you take the K is equal to 13.6 and U is equal to minus 27.2, so it will be, net will be the minus 13.6, total energy is minus 13.6, so that also you can check that way. Next question, 12.6. A hydrogen atom initially in the ground level absorbs a photon. When it is at the ground level, when it absorbs energy, it will go to the higher level. Correct? It is at the number 1, quantum number, that is n is equal to 1. So when it absorbs the photon, which excites it jumps from 1 to the 4, n is equal to 4 level. Determine the lambda and the frequency of the photon. We know that ground state energy of the photon is En is equal to minus 13.6 upon, energy is given in the n state, minus 13.6 upon n square. If n is equal to 1, first orbit will be 13.6 electron volt. So ground level 1, energy in the ground level n is equal to 1 level, that is say E1 is 13.6 electron volt minus with a minus sign. Correct? It is bounded with the nucleus. Energy in the fourth level will be 1/4, that will decrease, but negative, so actually it is more. This is less, because it is minus. Absolutely it is more, but it is actually less. So this much difference of the energy, correct? This minus this, that will be the energy of the photon emitted. Say it is delta E. Delta E is equal to E4 minus E1. E4 is minus 0.85 minus E1 is minus, so minus minus 13.6 electron volt. This will be plus. So the actually difference of this energy will be emitted in the terms of photon. So delta is equal to 12.75 electron volt. This difference is, this is a plus and this is minus. So difference will be plus 12.75 electron volt. Convert into joules, 12.75 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. That will be converted into joule, volt into coulomb is joule. Correct? Charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. That is coulomb into volt, that will be joule. So now delta E is equal to, or you can say E also, E2 minus E1 also anyway, is equal to H nu. So nu is the frequency and that is equal to C upon lambda. Velocity is equal to frequency into wavelength. Velocity is equal to frequency into lambda. So frequency is equal to C upon lambda, or lambda is equal to C upon nu. Correct? Whichever you want to calculate. So lambda, H nu is equal to SC upon lambda. Nu is equal to C upon lambda. So SC upon lambda. So lambda is equal to SC upon delta E. So H is the Planck constant, 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second into velocity of light, 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second upon delta E. Delta E is 12.75 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joules. This calculation comes about 0.975 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter. That is equal to 975 Aston unit. Correct? It's a very less. This is ultra in the higher ultraviolet region. Now nu is equal to C upon lambda. The frequency lambda we have calculated. Again, frequency, that is C upon lambda, that is velocity is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. And lambda is 975, already we have calculated, to 10 raised to minus, Aston unit, that is 10 raised to minus 10. That is over 3.077 into 10 raised to 50 hertz. Frequency values will be on the power of generally 10 raised to 14 or 15, except radio waves. They have less frequency because wavelengths are longer, they are many kilometers sometimes. So lambda is answer, lambda is 975 Aston unit and frequency is 3, almost 3 into 10 raised to 15 hertz. Example 12.9, a 12.75 electron volt electron beam is used to bombard a hydrogen atom at the gaseous hydrogen at room temperature. What series of wavelengths will be emitted? At room temperature, hydrogen is generally at the ground state. when it is imparted this much energy, it will go into the jump into the excited state. This state that we have to first calculate. So delta E, that is equal to 12.75 electron volt. Energy, we know energy is equal to 13.6 electron volt upon n square. It decreases as the n is to square. Negative, that is actually it will increase. For n is equal to 1, ground state, that is this one. So E1 is equal to, n is equal to 1, so this is 1, so minus 13.6 electron volt, we know that. What is the energy of hydrogen atom at ground, in the ground state? The n is equal to 1, minus 13.6 electron volt. So energy of an electron in the excited state, after absorbing the photon, 12.75 electron volt energy becomes, the total energy becomes this energy in the ground state plus it absorbs this much energy from the electron photon, beam of electron associated with the photon, that is equal to 0.85 electron volt. So it will go to the fourth excited state. This is 0.85 electron volt, correct? Therefore, n square is equal to minus 13.6 upon En. En we have calculated the energy of electron, correct, is equal to, that is the same equation, En is equal to minus 13.6 upon n square. N square we have to take here, we have calculated the En. So n square is equal to 13.6 upon En. So En is the, we don't know the En, we have to calculate the N. 13.6 upon minus 13.6 upon minus 0.85, that is equal to 16. That is N square is equal to 16, N is equal to 4. So it will be 4 in the fourth excited state. Thus, electron gets excited to N is equal to 4 state. The total number of lambda wavelength in emission spectra is given by the n into bracket n minus 1 by 2. So n is 4. So 4 into 4 minus 1, that is 3. 3 into 4, that is 12. 12 by 2, that is 6. Or you can see also for excited state. From 4 it will jump to the ground state. Then it will 4 to the second, 4 to the third. So 3 lines are here. Then it can jump from 3rd to the 1, 3rd to the 2 also. Now this stage is left. It can jump from the 3rd to the, this totally 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Correct? This is the maximum energy, so maximum frequency and minimum wavelength. The shorter is the length, longer is the wavelength emitted. Correct. The energy is very less. So nu is very less. Nu is very less. So energy is less. Energy is less, then frequency will be less. Lambda will be longest. Energy is equal to h nu. And that is equal to h. Nu is equal to c upon lambda. Correct. So energy directly proportional to nu. So energy is more, this is energy is more, so nu will be more. Whatever. So lambda will be, energy is more, lambda will be least. This is maximum, this is minimum, like that. So emitted wavelength, lambda IF is equal to SC upon lambda. SC upon lambda. So lambda is equal to SC upon E. E, that is energy, that is EI minus EF, the difference between the two orbits. Correct. So lambda IF is equal to this calculation, H is equal to SC, that is 6.6 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second into velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second upon energy difference between two levels or states or orbits. So lambda IF is equal to 19.8 into 10 raised to minus 26, this one, meter, this product, 366, correct? upon EI minus EF. So lambda, now let us see lambda 4, 3. Lambda 4, 3, when it jumps from 4 to the 3, because this is, it is excited to the 4th and it will, this is unstable, so it will fall back to any orbit. So it can fall back in 6 ways. That is lambda 4, 3 is equal to the same product upon EI minus EF. What is in the fourth? Fourth state, that energy is already we have calculated, that is 0.85, correct? 0.85 electron volt, or it is also you can see here 13.6 upon 16, correct? That is equal to 0.85 plus 1.5, correct? Energy here is 1.5. So energy difference when it jump from 4 to the 3, that is 4, 3, correct? Is energy here minus this one, minus minus plus. This will be minus minus, it is minus. So, and this is also minus, so minus minus will be plus. So 0.85 plus 1.5 into 10 is to 6 into 10 is to minus 19. This is in electron volt, so convert it to joules by multiplying 1.6 into 10 is to minus 19. So this already calculated 19.8 into this power you go 19, if you go take up, that will be minus power 7. So 10 is to minus 7 into this 1.6, and this difference is 0.66 into 1.6. This difference, correct? This addition, that is sum. This is minus, so we have to take the 1.5 minus 0.85, that is 0.66 into 1.6. That is 28.8409 into 10 is to minus 7 meter. So this is least energy, so nu is least and lambda is maximum. So lambda will be 28409 Austin unit, correct? Convert into Austin unit. Longest wavelength, minimum frequency. Now lambda 4 to the 2. This is frequency is more, correct? Here frequency is least, here frequency more. 19, this is already we have calculated, 19.8 into 10 raised to minus 26 upon 0.85 plus, this is the, what is the energy on the 2? That is minus 3.4, the minus minus plus. So 4 2 will be 0.85 minus 0.85 plus this one. Minus 0.85 plus 3.4. This difference is 2.55. And this is already we know that 19.8 into 10 is to power minus 7 upon this difference into 1.6. That comes about this 4852.9 Austin unit. Directly I have written, correct? So lambda 4 1, that is when it jump from 4 to the 1, the maximum frequency and minimum wavelength. Wavelength will go on decreasing if line becomes longer, that the difference is more. That is 19.8 into 10 to the minus 26 into minus 0.85 minus minus plus. What is the energy here? Minus 13.6, that is plus, minus minus will be plus. So 13.6, this difference is 12.75 into 21. That comes about 970.6 Austin unit. Now lambda 3 2, that is equal to 19.8 into 10 raised to minus 26 upon lambda 3 2 2, that is what is the energy in the this is third 1.51 minus 1.51 minus minus 3.4, that is plus 3.4, that is on the 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. That comes about this calculation 6/47.6 unit. Similarly, you can calculate the 3 1 and this is 3, 2, this is 3, 2, you can calculate the 3, 1 also same way, and finally 2, 1, correct. I leave it to you. Units 1 nanometer is 10 raised to minus 9 meter, you know 1 Austin unit is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meters, and 1 Fermi meter is 10 raised to minus 515 meter. This unit is used for the radius of the nucleus. This we use for the radius of the atom. This we will see in the next chapter, nuclear. Next example 12.7. Using the Bohr's model, calculate the velocity of the electron in a hydrogen atom in first, second and third levels. That is first orbit, second level orbits and the third orbit. N is equal to 1, N is equal to 2, N is equal to 3. Number 1, 2. This is E. Calculate the orbital period in each of these levels and calculate the time period also. The speed of the electron in the Bohr's nth orbit is, already we know, Vn is equal to 2 pi k e square upon nh. That is equal to, this is actually V and n is the orbit, so we say it is V1, the V1 by n. Velocity in the first orbit divided by n. Vn already we know, that is 1 upon n in e square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 1 upon h upon 2 pi, that is equation 12 and 14 on page number 425 of your book. So 4 pi epsilon 0, that you can write as a k. So k e square, this will go up 2 pi k e square upon n into h, correct. Same way, but here speed of the electron in Bohr's first orbit, that is n is equal to 1, first level, this first n is equal to 1 orbit is V1, you put it V1, n is equal to 1, that is 2 pi k e square upon h. So 2 pi, 2 into 3.14, k is 9 into 10 raised to 9, and electron charge 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 is square, that is square upon Planck's constant 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second. That comes about 2.186 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. Now you know velocity decreases, or it is inversely proportional to n. So if radius becomes double, it will be half. If radius becomes third, it will be one third, and so on. So V2 will be V1 by 2. Put n is equal to 2. This is V1 divided by n is equal to 2 instead of 1. That will be divide this magnet value divided by 2. That will be half of this. That is 1.093 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. Then divide this by 3, that is you will get V3. V3 is equal to V1 upon 3. That is equal to 0.729 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. Now orbital period of electron in Bohr's first orbit. That is first orbit T1 is equal to circumference of the orbit, that is 2 pi R1 upon velocity in the first orbit. That is V1, we already calculated. That is 2 into 3.14 into radius, Bohr radius we know already, 0.53 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter, correct, which Bohr calculated. Upon velocity we have already calculated, in the first orbit 2 into 2.186 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. So T1, this calculation is 1.52 into 10 raised to minus 16 second. Very less time, correct. So now as Tn is n cube up into T1, the Kepler's third law, you know, correct, the time period is directly proportional to cube of the radius. This is the radius, n is the orbit. So T2 is equal to, in the two orbit, that is r cube or n cube, n is the orbit number, is a principal quantum number here we call. So 2 cube into T1, that is T1 into 2 cube, that is already T1 is calculated, 1.52 into 10 raised to minus 16 second, multiply this. Answer is 1.216 into 10 raised to minus 15 second. So T3 is 3 cube, radius cube, into 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6 second. So more is the number n, more will be the time taken by the electron to revolve right this, correct? So this is more time. T3 is 4.1 into 10 raised to minus 15 second. Thus V1 is this 2.186 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second, V2 is 1.098 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second, and V3 is 0.729 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. So these are the timings and these are the velocity. This is T1, T2, T3, V1, V2 and V3, correct? Next example, 12.8. The radius of the innermost electron orbit of a hydrogen atom is 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter. Correct? We have seen just now. What is the radii of the n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3 orbits? Correct? Other orbits. So, first n is equal to 1 orbit is given. We have to calculate the second and third. So, Rn is given already, radius in the first orbit is 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter, correct? Or you can write 0.53 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter, or you can write 0.53 astral unit also. So, radius Rn is given by, it is n square R1. Radius is increases as a square of the quantum number or orbit number or level number. So, R2 is equal to 2 square will be 4 times, radius will be 4 times in the second orbit, 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11, that is equal to 2.112, this 4 into 5, this calculation you could, correct, that will be 21.2, but power is minus 11, so it will be minus 10. So R3 will be 9 times, 3 square into radius of the orbit in the when n is equal to 1, 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11, that is 4.77 into 10 raised to minus 10 meters, correct? So R1 is 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11, R2 is, this is 4 times than this, 2.12 into 10 raised to minus 10 meters, this is a 9 times, 4.77 into 10 raised to minus, this ratio is 1:9. This ratio is 1:4. 12.10 and last example of this exercise. In accordance with the Bohr's model, this example is asked in the examination also. In accordance with the Bohr's model, find the quantum number that characterizes the Earth's revolution around the Sun in an orbit of radius 1.5 into 10 raised to 11 meter. This is the orbit of the Earth radius around the Sun. You know, the Sun takes about, the light takes about 500 seconds to reach from the Sun to the Earth. That is, it travels at the speed of 3 lakh kilometers. So, multiply, you will get this figure, the 1.5, that is, light takes from the Sun, say S, to the Earth. It takes 500 seconds. So, light travels at the speed of 3 lakh kilometer, correct? So, distance is equal to velocity c into t. C, you know, 3 into 10 raised to 8, and time is 500 seconds. That is equal to 15 into 10 raised to 8 and 2 10, that is 10 meter. This is the distance of the, so what you can write 1.5, that is equal to 1.5 into 10 raised to 11 meter. That is 15 crore kilometer also, or you can say in kilometer, the 15 into 10 raised to 7 kilometer. That is a very large distance from the Sun to the Earth. And orbit of the radius is this, that is the radius, this distance, correct? Radius of the orbit of the Earth goes around the Sun. with orbital speed, the speed of the Earth is also 3 into 10 is to 4 meter, that is 30 kilometer. Speed of the Earth, this it goes at the, around the Sun, and the speed of V is equal to 30 kilometer per second, or you can write 3 into 10 raised to 4 meter per second. This was measured by the Michelson-Morley experiment. 3 into 10 raised to 4 meter per second mass of the Earth. Mass of the Earth is 6 into 10 raised to 24. This mass of the Earth is, that is ME. You have studied in 11, 6 into 10 raised to 24 kg, correct? Mass of the Sun, you know, is 2 into 10 raised to power 30 kilogram. And mass of the galaxy is 3 into 10 raised to 41 kilogram. This already you have studied, and that is why if you take the ratio mass of the galaxy to mass of the Sun, that is 3 by 2, 1.5 into 10 raised to 11, that is we say that in galaxy there are 10 raised to 11 stars. That is already you have studied. Now we have to see the another thing here, correct? We have to calculate the quantum number, correct? So we know that second quantization condition of Bohr atomic model, the angular momentum of the Earth, angular momentum of the Earth around when it goes around this, as electron goes around the nucleus, it is mvr is nh upon 2 pi, v is the velocity of the Earth, r is the radius of the Earth, that is this was distance, or we can say radius, that is also radius, and m is the mass of the Earth, this is, or me also you can use any. So n is equal to mvr into 2 pi, that is 2 pi mvr upon nh. N is 1, n is 1, that is divided by h. So n is equal to 2 into pi, that is 3.14 into mass of the Earth, 6 into 10 is to 24 power, and velocity of the Earth, that is 3 into 10 is to 4, 2 pi, that is 2 into 3.14, pi is 3.14. Mass is 6 into 10 raised to 24 kg, velocity of the Earth round the Sun is 30 kilometers, that is 3 into 10 raised to 4 meters, and radius of the Earth orbit, this distance, that is 1.5 into 10 raised to 11 meter, upon Planck constant 6.6 into 10 raised to minus 34. This comes about n is equal to 2.57 into 10 raised to power 74, it is a very high number, as you can see, it is not on the microscopic scale, it is a macroscopic scale, that is classical theory you can apply.